Sheriff, what a nice surprise. I'm not sure I've seen you here before. You're always welcome, of course. Is it business or pleasure? Or both?
I'm looking for someone.
Finding you someone is our specialty, but the club's closed.
Not quite what I meant.
That's too bad. I guess you'd better talk to Georgie. You're in luck. He's here. Come on. I should warn you that Georgie does not like to be bothered when he's working. And he's in kind of a mood right now. I mean, more so than usual.
It'll be fine. I have a way with people.
So I've heard. Welcome to the Pudding and Pie, where we cater to the diverse tastes of the Fable community. Your pleasure is our pleasure. Your desires are our desires. Your imagination is the menu, and discretion is our guarantee.
You can skip the spiel. Save it for the customers.
Always looking for more customers.
What do you think you're doing? You look like you're trying to take a shit. Who's gonna want that? No one's gonna want that. You fucking dozy bitch.
Nice guy. Seems like a real prince.
You do have a sense of humor. That's good. Good luck.
It's your face. You have to smile. You never smile. How many times do I have to say it? You're supposed to turn the clients on. That's your job. You want them to feel happy. You want them to think you feel happy. You want them to forget about your shoulders and those fucking narrow hips. You want them to get so worked up that they'll stuff their wallet straight up your fucking cunt. You want them so out of their minds, blind with excitement, that they'll hop their houses and carpet this floor with money just to get their grimy little paws on you. But they're not going to do any of that if you don't ever flash them a bloody smile. You know what they're going to do? They're going to take their business elsewhere because you're making them feel fucking miserable. You're supposed to be reeling them in. Instead, you're driving them out the fucking door. Jesus God, you're killing me. I don't think you're even trying. But we're going to keep at this until you get it right. Oh, it's you. We're closed. Keep dancing, you. I didn't say stop. For fuck's sake. You, stay right there. Don't even think about sitting down. We're not finished.
I got a few questions.
Imagine my excitement.
What do you want then? You here for a little taste? Tell you what, come back after midnight maybe. I can hook you up. Or, knowing you, she's probably not quite your style. You'd prefer someone who can take a bit of a beating. Tell me, do you prefer a stationary target or one that will put up a fight? I can arrange whatever you like for the right price.
I'm not here for that.
Oh, I'm not here for that. You just stopped in for the chips then.
Jesus, Bigby, you're so corny.
I love it though.
No, seriously, I love it.
Okay, all right, Sheriff. Just fucking with you.
Look, I know why you're here.
Are you sure?
Listen, Sheriff. Around here, we can't afford to wait for you and your swanky pals to take an interest. We have to look out for each other. When shit happens, I hear about it. Especially if it concerns my livelihood.
In that case, I assume you knew Lily was glamoured.
Of course she was, you daft git. She was a troll.
No. I mean glamoured to look like another fable.
Yeah? Well, so what?
Who gives a toss? People get up to all kinds of things when nobody's watching. It's their own business.
It's sick.
Ha! That's quaint. Especially coming from you.
The 13th floor would never provide a glamour like that. It's strictly black market stuff.
Ooh, black market, is it? How exciting.
This is exactly what I would expect from a thug like you. Storm in, throw around a bunch of accusations, try to scare people. But you've got fuck all to back it up.
And we're all just meant to jump any time the wolf shows his teeth. He used to be something, you know. Now look at him.
Nothing to back it up? Well, what the fuck is this, then?
Get that out of my face.
I found it on Lily's body, and it's definitely a back alley job. Where did she get it?
You've got this all wrong. If Lily was doing a special glamour, it wasn't for me. For fuck's sake, I want that kind of heat.
Who was she doing it for, then?
She had clients, Bigby. Maybe one of them was into it. A lot of fucked up people in Fable Town.
Like who?
Try looking in the mirror. Anyway, now to do with me. Go on then. You're gonna hit me? Go ahead. That's what you wanna do, right? That's what you came here for, right? That's what you like.
Tell me what I want to know, or I'll shut this whole place down.
Oh, no, fuck! You! Take your sad fucking face where I can't see it!
Bloody bastard fucking shit! You proud of yourself, mate? Proud of your little mess? Fuck's sake.
Hold on a minute. Hans, is it?
Hans just cleans up and provides a little muscle when we need it. He's not gonna know anything about the girls and their clients or any of that. No one knows. Don't you get it? It's by design. Discretion is our guarantee, right? And the way we guarantee that is that no one knows anything they don't have to know, including me. I cover my eyes and take my cut. End of story.
Why not look it up?
What's that?
Isn't there a little book with all the stuff about the girls and all that written in it?
You're a fucking moron!
Show me.
There is no book.
And as for you, Hans, we need to work on your communication skills and have a fairly good idea where to start.
Hey, that's my personal property. Sure, go ahead. Do what comes naturally.
Oh no! You unbelievable prick! Hey now!
Shouldn't have messed with that.
Don't even think about it.
Look, Georgie, why don't you just tell me where the book is?
Can we please not go round and round about this? There's no book. End of story.
Do not touch that. You hear me? That's nothing to do with you.
Well, well, what's this? Looks like a floor safe.
I wouldn't know. It was here when we moved in. I don't have a key to it. Sheriff, will you come on? Fuck's sake, I've got to open up in a few hours.
Give it to me.
You're a big bad bastard. We get it. Everyone's guilty. We fucking get it.
Jesus, you're killing me. I'm begging you. I'll pay you.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Come on, Nate. Leave it. There's nothing there for you.
You might want to stand back.
All right, all right, all right. Bloody come on, then. Fucking trash my business over this bullshit. Protector of Fable Town, my ass. What a load of crap. Once again, don't get your hopes up. There's nothing in here that'll tell you anything. But it's a kick to the balls for me and my club, so we can be happy about that.
Here, this is Lily's last entry. So tell me, Georgie, who's this Mr. Smith?
Oh dear, I'm afraid it might be a fake name, Bigby. Secrecy is sort of how this all works. Even Ance knows that.
What's 207? Room number?
I don't fucking know. Millimeters, maybe?
Don't bullshit me, Georgie. This is your book. Your girls.
I'm not their fucking secretary. I give them a stage. I give them music. I provide an erotic venue to attract and retain clients. But let's be clear on something. The girls make the arrangements with their clients, not me. The girls. They're the ones with the Mr. Smiths and Joneses and Mr. X types. Whatever happens outside the club, that's on them. I log the business, take my cut, and I'm out. Now, I've had quite enough of you and your bullying. Excuse me while I call your superiors to make a complaint. Hello? Business office? Yeah, that's right.
Lipstick, lip gloss, compact, glitter. Broken open, but there isn't even a lock. Lock's been busted open. Faith. Faith, thanks for covering for me tonight. Let's talk before you go over to the apartment. Lily. Looks like they both saw one of Lily's clients. Excuse me.
I heard you out there. I don't remember ever seeing you here before.
I'm here now.
Yes. You're trying to place me. They used to call me the Little Mermaid. Once upon a time. Does that help?
What do they call you now?
Whatever makes them happy. My name is Nerissa.
Well, Nerissa, I've got some questions.
Of course you do. I don't have answers. You'll have to find those yourself.
Does the number 207 mean anything to you? I assumed it was a room number, but where?
We can't talk about work.
This is a murder case.
I mean can't. These lips are sealed. Discretion is our guarantee. It's how things work here. By design.
People keep using those phrases. What does it mean? This is what I need to know about. Lily's last entry. Who's Mr. Smith? Where's room 207? I have to know.
These lips. Sheriff Wolf, would you like to make an appointment with me?
Okay. What would I need to do?
I need 150. It's not good to be short.
This isn't enough, but it's all I've got.
Wait here for a second.
Not 207?
You'll think of something.
The open arms. This is where they met.
Enjoy your stay. I hope you find what you're looking for.
Want it by the hour, or for the whole night?
You...
I work here, okay? I work the front desk. It's to help pay rent. So, now you know.
I know I should have told somebody, but Beast would lose his mind if you knew.
Beast is a proud man, Bigby. He wants to do right by me, and he just couldn't handle it if he knew I had to do this so we don't get evicted. All of our friends live at the Woodlands. He'd be mortified.
You should really tell Beast. He's worried about you.
I will. I just need to in my own time. By the way, thanks for covering for me. So, what are you doing here? Oh, you have a key.
Someone else was murdered last night.
I heard.
The victim was someone who worked at the Pudding and Pie. Lily, she, come around here ever?
Oh,
Oh, yes, the troll. I did see her. I mean, you know, we never really spoke, but she came off a tad intimidating.
Ever meet a girl named Faith? Or just maybe hear that name?
I might have. I don't know. By the end of the night, it's kind of a blur with all the names. Tara, Brandy, Amber, Heather... Sorry.
Ever see Lily with someone here? Maybe on a job?
Sometimes, but nobody I've recognized. I haven't worked here that long, though.
How about a room register? Or someone named Mr. Smith?
That's all we get here. Smiths, Jones, or Johnsons. I think the last ones are jokes.
I talked to Tweedledee earlier today. He mentioned you in passing. Do you know him, or his brother?
I took out a loan. For back pay. It was like our third notice. And ever since then, those annoying freaks have been pestering me for the money, plus interest.
Why take out a loan from those two?
It was from the crooked man.
Beauty.
You don't know how desperate I was, Bigby. I had nowhere else to go.
Look, if this ever happens again, come see me or Snow first, all right?
I tried.
Have you seen Snow White down here? Or maybe somebody glamored as her?
You know, it's funny. I did see someone who I thought looked a lot like her, but she didn't say anything when she saw me, even though she knew that I saw her. I just assumed it wasn't Snow and went about my business.
Thanks.
Wait. It'll be better if anyone sees you, that they at least see you with me, so they know that I didn't let you just wander around by yourself. 5 minutes, please.
We'll see, Beauty.
Just be ready to act like I'm trying to kick you out.
That won't be hard.
Listen, Bigby. I assume you'll be filing some kind of an official report or something. Which is fine, it's just that I was wondering if I need to be in it. Do you have to mention my name? I mean, it's not like Beast would ever see your report. It's just, well, you never know.
It's not much of a report if I start picking and choosing which facts to include.
I see. Well, here we are. Which one was it?
Sure why they have desks in a place like this. You get health inspectors through here very often?
I don't know. What do you think? Finding what you're looking for?
I wasn't expecting much in here.
But isn't this why you're here? Why you have the key?
No. The key was just to be sure I found the right hotel. This isn't the room Lily was using.
Oh. So, are we done now?
No. The room they met in was 207. You have keys to these rooms?
I thought you had a key.
Not to this one.
Hold on, Bigby. I can't just let you go into any room you want. I mean, what if someone's in there? You can't just go barging in.
Please.
Ugh, fine.
Hey, what the fuck?
Sorry.
Jesus Christ! You're gonna get me fired! I need this job.
I'll be careful. Seven. Open this one.
Well, that's weird. This key is supposed to open every room in the building, but it's not working.
Beauty!
Ah, shit.
Beast?
Big B? How could you do this to me?
No, sweetie, no. Wait a minute.
How could you do this? We've been together through everything. I took care of you. I love-
It's not what you think. Please.
You're cheating on me! With him?
No, no, Beast! I promise I'm not! I'm helping him, that's all!
I'll bet! I'm sure you help each other just great! I know what this place is! I know what goes on here!
That's not what I meant!
This is a murder investigation. She's helping me-
Stop lying to me! What the fuck is wrong with you? She's my wife!
Beast, listen to me! There's nothing going on! I'm not-
Hey!
Bastard! I guess I finally see you for who you are!
Stop! Stop it!
I knew you were sneaking around!
Listen to your wife! Just calm down and-
Beast!
This? Bigby.
Look what you did to the door! You can't just act like this whenever
Stand
you-
Stand back! You don't want to see this.
Well, we got the door open.
Oh my god!
Don't touch anything.
Is this?
Lily met her client here. Mr. Smith, whoever he is.
And then?
Must have happened right here.
Jesus.
Last night?
Yeah.
I was on shift last night.
On shift? Beauty, what?
I'm not a prostitute, you idiot. I work the front desk.
So that's...
Yeah.
Still, this is no place for someone like you. I mean, look.
Can we please not talk about this?
Did you notice anything out of the ordinary? There might have been some loud noises.
I don't know. I mean, loud noises aren't out of the ordinary. I didn't hear anyone screaming or anything like that, but shouldn't I have? It just seemed like a totally normal night. How is that even possible? There's so much blood.
Go lock the front door. Keep people out of the hallway. I need you to be sure no one comes in here. This is a crime scene, okay?
But...
Just do what he says. I'll explain later, okay? Bigby, what kind of a person could do something like this?
That's exactly what I'm about to try to find out.
I can't believe this.
Do all the rooms have these same clocks with the built-in cassette player?
I think so, yes. Where'd you get that?
Lily had it in her hand, in case there was any doubt over who died here.
What is that?
It's a book about Snow White. Or about the Mundy version of her story, anyway.
The whole book is about her?
Yeah.
Why is she in a glass coffin?
This is the part where she's in a deep sleep, but they think she's dead.
What's it mean? Why mark the page where she's sleeping?
I think he made up the bed to match the coffin in the picture. Flowers, too. He'd have had Lily lie down just like this.
You mean just before?
In the story, that's when someone comes to kiss her. That's our Mr. Smith.
This is creepy. The coffin and the weird fixation on Snow. What the hell is wrong with this guy?
It's a huff and puff.
I thought you were the only one who smoked that crap brand.
Apparently not. He brought wine.
Classy.
Someone's been rough with this dress. It's torn.
Oh no, she must have been wearing it. He killed her and then he took it back off?
No, there's no blood on it. It must have been torn some other time.
What are you thinking?
This is the same dress as the one in the book about Snow. I think Smith was dressing Lily up in it, to recreate the snow from the book.
You're right. It's the same dress. It fits. He's acting out scenes from the book. That poor girl. She couldn't have known. She probably just needed the money. She could have been anyone. How did she wind up here? I mean, not exactly here, but just how does a person...
Georgie took advantage of her when she was in trouble. He's a real predator.
Yeah. She must have been so scared.
Is there anything else you can tell me about last night? Anything that sticks out in your mind?
Sorry, no. It just seemed like every other night does. That's exactly what's bothering me. From now on, I'll just be down there imagining this.
How can I find out who rented this room?
Find whoever has the key? I'm pretty sure this one must be held long-term. And we don't keep a register or anything. This place is intentionally kind of anonymous.
I keep hearing that. I'd better not find out you're hiding something from me about all this.
What the hell is wrong with you? I'm not involved in this! Please, just do whatever you need to do, and let's get out of here. Maybe she didn't see it coming. Bigby, this? I think I heard this music. last night. It was playing pretty loudly for a while and then stopped in the middle. I didn't think twice about it at the time. I mean, you hear all kinds of things around here, and I guess I've already gotten used to blocking them out.
Could have covered up the sound of the murder.
Damn it. Get it together, Beauty. Be strong.
Do you smell something?
No. Just apple.
Oh no, there's more? What? What now?
It's got a single bite taken out of it, like in Snow's story.
Oh no, do you think it was poisoned?
It wasn't. I'd have smelled that. I think it's just a prop. It's here because they were acting out the scene in the book.
Of course. That makes perfect sense. He's just acting out another part of the book. God, I can see the whole picture now. It all goes together like you said. This creep put that girl in a Snow White dress and recreated the whole story from the book with the apple and the deep sleep and everything. You're a better detective than I thought you'd be.
Thanks.
So he planned it all out. He had all the details noted down. Only then, when it comes time to kiss her and wake her up.
Yeah.
I hope you're just about through. I don't really want to stay in here any longer. Pictures of the dead girl?
Not all of her.
How do you know?
I'm in this one. It was taken last winter.
Oh no. Bigby. This kind of stalking, it doesn't just stop by itself. Trust me, I know about this firsthand. He'll keep trying to get closer and closer.
His stand-in for Snow is gone now, so...
The next step closer. What is it?
It's Crane.
He could be after you now.
Good. I am dying to get my hands on that disgusting weasel.
I'm really starting to like you, Sheriff. You're not afraid to be a complete bastard.
Obviously, there will have to be some changes.
Hello, Bigby.
Take care of it, Bigby, or I'll take care of it for you.
Jesus Christ, Bigby. Is that you?